anthropologist Faust.
Aged 5. Claire Shields, aged 6. Ian Russell, aged 8. Beverly Croft, aged 9. Patrick Mole, aged 6. Meet these children and others like them on Child's Play. And here's your host, Michael Aspel.
Hello, welcome to Child's Play, the game in which adults try to find out what's going on in children's minds, and may the Lord have mercy on their soul. Let's meet our first celebrity guest. Welcome, John Pertwee. Now, John, you've entertained a lot of children in your time, and you are a father as well.
Yes, I have a couple. I have a beautiful little pigeon pair, yes.
Of children?
Yes.
Oh, good. And you have a guest as well this evening. You're going to tell me who that is?
I have a guest, yes. Mrs. Chris Hope from Thetford in Norfolk.
Chris, I see that you're married to Bob Hope. He's a bit old for you, isn't he? You must get that every day of your life.
I do, yes.
Poor chap. And you've got, how many? 3 children. How old are they?
My daughter's 12. My second son is 10. And my youngest son is 5.
And you're interested in amateur dramatics, so it's a useful background for this one, isn't it?
Yes.
So good luck to you. And now let's welcome our second celebrity, Isla Blair. Isla. Isla and I last worked together having a gin and tonic on stage in a certain play,
indeed,
didn't we?
We did indeed, and tried not to laugh. We didn't succeed.
No, we laughed rather or not. Wrong times. Anyway, who provides the laughs at home? Jamie, how old is he?
Jamie's 14 now, yeah. I'm afraid, yes.
And he's interested in all sorts of things?
Yes, cricket is the passion, and golf at the moment, and drama. Wants to be an actor. What can I do to
stop? Sounds like you're married to John Pertwee, doesn't it? Anyway, let's meet your guest, please.
Yes, this is Andy Cameron, and he comes from Great Langdale, near Ambleside in Cumbria.
You're in the hotel business. Do you have to handle difficult customers?
We get a 1 or 2 every now and then.
Yes, it's a lovely part of the world, isn't it? You're interested in stocks and shares. Have you had any good wins?
We started at school in the sixth form, and I'm just studying it now for a few months with a view to try and start up fully in it.
Well, you might carry away a little gold or silver this very night, so good luck to all of you. As you may know, what happens in this game is that we've taken our cameras around the country and looked at children aged between 5 and 11, and we've asked them to define certain simple everyday words, and our panels have to guess what those words are. Children, of course, look at things strangely, as we know, or rather differently from us. There's maybe the proper way for all we know. So if for an example of what you're going to see, let's hear how Claire Shields, age 6 of Halifax, defined a certain word. The word is praise is Prime Minister. Would you recognise our beloved leader from this description?
Well, she's a bossy lady. And she shouts. And I don't know no else about her.
And not many of us do, of course. Sounds like a musical, Bossy Lady, with Barbara Streisand, doesn't it? Anyway, you can see it's quite easy. You would have guessed that at once. You have 3 versions of each word to help you guess. And now, who won the toss? It was John and Chris. So you're to lead, and we'll show the audience the first word that you have to guess. And here is Paul Sewell from Worcester. He's 7 years old to define that word.
Well, they haven't got a beard. They haven't got hair. They're mainly shaped squares, sometimes square heads and square bodies. They sometimes talk in a strange language. I don't know the language. Talking quite often. Right, that's it. I don't know.
Well, that's it. He's exhausted himself, Paul. I tell you what, it's not disc jockey. So, John, for 15 points, what is he talking about?
Well, it sounds like a Dalek with hair. A Dalek.
You've committed yourself, and it isn't Dalek. That means the 15 points have gone. There are 10 remaining, and I offer it now to Andy on the other side. Andy, another definition. Can you guess by what Gabby Wine, who is 7 from East Sheen, says?
Well, they work in factories, and they help, they do men's jobs. And they're automatic and you have to program them to do what you like, that you want them to do.
I think I've met a few of those. What do you say then, Andy?
Computers.
That awful noise tells you you are wrong, so we have one more to see. And, Chris, it's back to you for 5 points, and I'm glad we're going to see this one because it's a very graphic... Is he giving clues? I didn't see that. Right, a graphic description from Patrick Mould, age 6, from Worcester.
It's made out of metal and it has no heart. And it doesn't laugh when you tell it a joke. Instead of hiding like bone inside it, it's all wires. There's not enough room for a heart. And it goes talks like this. You are a prisoner.
Thank you, Patrick. Yeah. You wish you'd seen that one, don't you, John? It would have been Dalek, wouldn't it? If you'd seen that, you'd been absolutely sure, but it wasn't Dalek. So, Chris, what's the answer?
I would say robot.
Yes. Right, 5 points for that. Another word coming up. Here it is for our audience, and Beverly Croft, who is 9 years old, of Sandy, will now do the defining.
It's when you go all shaky, and I... was it this morning? And sometimes my mum gets it when we're going to be late for school.
Well, Beverly, I think we've all been it, really. Isla Blair, 15 points on this for you. What do you say?
Could it be sick?
It could be, certainly the way you're looking at the moment. But no, that isn't the answer. Another chance this time for you, Chris. A couple of people this time, and they come from East Sheen, and they're Alice and Luke Hargreaves, age 6 and 10.
You're it when you're in front of the school, when you're going for an audition.
You're a teacher.
You jump on your bike.
In
being filmed.
Chattered with your teeth. Your knees knocking together.
Doesn't sound very nice. It isn't sick. What do you think, Chris?
Nervous.
That was worth 10 points to you. Very good indeed. Here's another word then, and this time it'll be for you, John, to start off again. Listen now to Victoria Baker and Michelle Brown, a pair of 9-year-olds from Newark.
I think from looking at it from somewhere, it will be all red. They could just see it in sort of a darkish brown in all the things in the background. I think there'll be churches and just square things, but there will be shops and things like that. But they would just look as if they were sort of boxes. And, another thought is inside. I think they'll sort of be like a cave with all little narrow parts leading and all the people laying on the floor and mumbling and groaning and moaning.
Well, thank you, girl. It sounds like a pub I know in Wandsworth High Street. But, John, what is your guess? What do you think of that?
Well, now, would it be a television set?
Well, when you find out the word, you might change your mind. Over to the other side, to Andy now, for 10 points, and listen to Layla Botton. She's 9 of Newark. Here's her definition.
I don't think they would have a telly. Just sit and pray, and they wear white long robes with gold belt and Jesus sandals.
Thank you, Layla. Does that help you, Andy?
Convent.
Convent. A nice answer. The wrong one. Back to John and Chris, and to Chris in particular. Another double-hander here for you, Chris, from Neil Smith and Lee Cowley, 10 and 6, respectively, of Newark.
Well, it's a place where you go up this dark, dark tunnel, and there's these gigantic doors at the end of the thing. They've plated gold, and there's this great big light, and you're like, it's like that, and you have to close your eyes.
Well, I think he's been there. Chris, what do you say? 5 points.
Heaven.
Heaven. You've got 20 points there. Now, here's another word as we watch Daniel Reeve, age 6, of Stevenage, doing this word.
You can
make things with it. We could bury something in it. We could throw it. Sometimes you get it all over your clothes.
Well, Isla, there's a lot of it about, obviously. What do you think it is?
Can it possibly be mud?
Oh! Glorious mud, yes. By Jove, you needed those points. Well done. And that brings us to the end of that round. You scored just in time, and the score now is Chris and John 20, Isla and Andy 15. And now we come to our triple play round, in which we asked children to write down descriptions of single words, and we chose three definitions of each word. Each team will have 45 seconds to guess as many words as possible, and each correct guess is worth 10 points. Now, you're behind on the score then, Isla and Andy, so you're going to start off, and who have you decided will represent you?
Andy is.
And right, here is the first one. I shall read the definitions for you, and you can guess after each one or call for another clue. Remember, the more clues you call for, the more time you're using up. 45 seconds on our countdown line, please. Now, first definition, it happens in traffic.
Jam.
Is right. Second word, it smells horrible.
Cayenne.
You get them with hot dogs.
Bun.
It makes you cry.
Onion.
Onion, right. Next word, a baby uses one.
Rattle.
It's when you go mad.
Dummy.
You can keep it under your bed.
Rattle?
Potty is the answer. You get it on a ship.
Deck.
Is right. Next word. It shines in the dark.
Light.
Is right. Next word. To close something up.
Shut.
An animal found in the Arctic Ocean.
Bear.
They balance things on their noses.
Penguin.
Seal is the answer. Next word. Medicine can taste like it.
Sweet.
When... I just started that one, so I'll finish that next clue. When something is sour.
Bitter.
Yes, that's the answer. Well done. So you've put your score up now to 65. Chris and John, it is your turn. Who's going to do it?
Well, I think I'd be crazy to do it. Not having got one single thing right. Chris, of course.
A wise decision. Chris, are you ready for the definitions? 45 seconds up on the screen. Here's the first definition. The Queen goes to them.
Occasions.
A round object containing air.
Balloon.
You hit it with a bat.
Ball.
A ball. Next word, your teeth grow in it.
Gum.
Gum is right. Next word, children have them at school.
Lessons.
To shatter or snap.
Smash.
It's when you stop for a snack.
Bite.
Break is the word. Next word, to see everything is safe in the house.
Lock.
When you lose at chess, a square in a pattern.
Check
is the answer. Next word, when you go on a journey.
Travel.
It's when you fall over. You can stumble over a brick.
Fall.
No, it's trip. Next word, you drink out of it.
Cup.
It's made of sand.
Castle.
It's sharp and you cut yourself. You've got a chance for one more. Yes. It's sharp and you cut yourself.
Glass,
yes. Oh, yes. Well, that's a handy little score now. It's 50 to Chris and John, and Isla and Andy have 65, so that's all right. And things could change very quickly. We'll be back in a moment with more child's play, but here's a definition to leave you with. Keep you chuckling while the commercials are on. What the word love means to Ian Russell. Ian is 8 of Worcester. Ian, what is love?
Romance.
I'll always be grateful for being given 9 lives. You see, not every cat gets 9 lives. Shame, really. These new meat dinners are chunkier and juicier. And when it says rabbit, you can really taste the rabbit. And the chicken. Oh, you can really taste the chicken. Yes, there are times when I really need my 9 lives. Tuesdays, generally.
A cat deserves new 9 lives once a week.
Or maybe twice.
Thank you.
delight, full of Eastern promise.
Playmates, Charles plays the name of the game. The scores are Chris and John 50, Isla and Andy have 65, but that could change because we now come to our bonus round in which we've asked several children to describe the same word and we put them all together. Some of the children's definitions are bang on, some are way out, and they're all quite different. That's why a correct guess in this round gets 50 points. Now, as John and Chris are behind, you will start this time, and Chris, let me ask you if you will go first. Righto? Audience, here is the word.
It's a person who's very sensible and cooks, and they don't play with toys, and they're a lot sensible. They're very sensible.
People that are 20 or 21 and 19.
They can be quite young, or about 83 or something. I've got two in my house. That's my mum and dad. It's when you're 32 or 21 and you don't go to school unless you're a teacher, and then you go to night school, and then you kind of go to work and do jobs like being a nurse and stuff, what we can't do.
Well, there's an interesting selection for you, Chris. It's when you're 32 or 21, they can be quite young, or about 83. They go to school, they don't play with toys, and they're a lot sensible, very sensible. What's the word?
Adult.
50 points to you. Misleading, that one, of course, because I play with toys. I don't know about you, John. Right, here's the next word, and this will be for Andy to guess. Audience, are you ready? Here it comes on the screen.
Bye. Eggs and spit the shell out. Well, they look horrible and they live underground and they eat little animals.
They're little and they eat grass. And they've got spots. It's quite long and it moves around a lot.
They make sort of buzzing noises, like bees.
It sometimes frightens people away.
Well, thanks, kids. According to that, there can't be a lot of them about. But anyway, good luck to you, Andy. What do you think?
Can only think a ferret.
Well, why not? It could just as well be. Isla, you can say...
Wow, sounds repulsive, whatever it
yes.
is.
Yes.
Oh. Weasel.
Oh, I thought you were going to say it for a moment there. The answer is snake. Ooh. Yes, quite. You may well say oh. Yes. Are you afraid of snakes? Most people are.
Passionately horrified.
They're actually, they're rather
I stood on a snake's head once when I was a little girl and it twisted its tail all around my foot.
I don't suppose a snake would all that please either. Anyway, 65 to 100 is the score now. And, of course, Isla and Andy are behind. But that may not be the end of things because we have now our fast play round. From now on, each child would define a different word, and this is where you plunge onto your buzzers, ladies and gents. As soon as you recognise the word, interrupt with the buzzer. Each correct answer is worth 20 points. If you interrupt, though, with a wrong answer, it will mean that your opposing team will see the whole of the definition and get the benefit, of course. Whoever gets the most out of this round, of course, is going to be the winner. We're not going to show anyone the word this time. We all play the game together. So here, first of all, is Michael Oxley, age 6 of Newcastle, with the first word.
You take what you put in your pillow away.
John and Chris.
Teeth.
No, you've interrupted too soon, so we will now allow Isla and Andy to see the rest of that definition.
And then leave you 40p, sometimes 41. Once they left me 41p, and once they left me 40p.
Well, the way he's going, he's going to be a rich man, I think. So, what do you say, Isla and Andy?
We think it's fairies.
Yes. Hard luck, John. Yes, I saw what you meant. The tooth...
You see what I meant, didn't you?
Absolutely.
Thank heavens for that.
But no point. Tooth fairy was the answer to that. Here's another word from Susan Sanders. She's 7 years old, from Sandy in Bedfordshire.
Well, they sort of look like bread, and they taste like it, and they've, normally they've got little bits of tomato and some melted cheese.
Who was that? That was Ilo and Andy. What do you say?
Pizza.
Pizza is right. Well done. Well instructed. 20 more points to you, and here's Angela Simmons, age 5, of Stevenage, with another definition.
Some people live in them, and you find them in special sort of camps. And
John and Chris?
Tent.
Not tent. A brave try, but you've gone too soon. Here's the rest of the definition for Isla and Andy.
Costs a bit more than tents. And some people live in them when they go on holiday, if they don't want to live in a hotel. And they're sort of an oval shape, and they've got about 4 wheels.
Is John vainly bashing his buzzer there? Far too late. Ilo and Andy?
Caravan.
Caravan, of course. Well done. On we go. Listen now to 9-year-old Katie Kenny of St. Helens.
We do cool things. We used to tell people about his father. We used to make people better and do miracles.
It was Chris who got there first, Chris.
Jesus.
Jesus is right. Well interrupted. 20 points there. Here's Kerry Farrell, age 8 of Newark. Another word.
Well, it's like a long stick, then a point on one end, and then on the other is a flight. And you throw it and it goes into...
Chris got there first.
Javelin.
A javelin is wrong. Now, how much more have we got for Ilo and Andy to hear on that one? On we go.
This big board.
Ah, there's a big clue at the end there.
Yeah.
Darts, you say? Right. Often the hangers on that last word, doesn't it? Here's another one. This is Andrew Wilson. He's 9. He's from Newcastle. Andrew?
It's like a modern teddy boy, but he's got hair different colours.
Chris?
Punk.
Well done. Very quick. Your score is creeping up there. But let's have another word from Darren Graham of Stevenage. He's 5.
They're crispy, they're white, and they've got fish inside, and...
Who did that? Was that John or Chris?
Chris.
What was it, Chris?
Scampi.
Oh, I see. Oh, very grand, Scampi. I don't know. Think
5 years?
Not sure that Darren, age 5, has tried Scampi, but he may have, but it's not the word, I'm afraid, so there's more to hear on that one. I think a little left for Andy and I.
They've got little round things on the top. And they're crunchy. They come in boxes and I like them.
Well, remember, he's 5 years old and that's the way he sees them. What do you say?
Fish fingers
is right. Your score is 165. You win. Well done. So Ilo and Andy win. Chris and John, very close indeed. A nice try indeed. You don't go home without anything. Chris, we give you a very pleasant award. And, of course, you've had the company of John. John, thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you.
And Andy, you get your special trophy and a hamper full of goodies. And, of course, Chris can get you in the playground afterwards. Ilo, thank you for being a lovely companion. We'll be doing it all again soon. I've heard from Jean Taylor of Chippenham, who said she was talking to her daughter about a pop group called Splinter, and the little girl, age 9, said, are they related to the Carpenters? Anyway, we'll be doing Charles Play again very soon. Bye-bye for now. We'll be right back.
Tonight at 8, culture. Well, almost.
Lingerman. I'll knock your flipping head off in a cat! Is going to do a soliloquy. Anyway, he's doing something from Hamlet.
Cannon and Ball at 8, Partners in Crime at 8:45, and money is changing hands.
£20 on the nose.
Right here.
They're all forgeries.
But where did she get them from?
She won them.
Counterfeit Money. Puzzle Partners in Crime at 8:45, preceded by comedy with Cannon and Ball at 8 tonight.
In a moment, before your very eyes, it's a magical 3-2-1.
For peace of mind, fit Zenith. Replacement windows and doors.
With Blue Sky, you can look forward to a summer holiday that's better value than ever. And with thousands of holidays costing less than last year, you just can't wait to get there.
Now, where was I?
Blue Sky. Money-saving holidays without clouds.
Oh, piggies!
We are the Wessex, the piggies, a family of beautiful porcelain pigs. We give them this wobbly wall jar, a cart, a folded two boots. What a wonderful bundle of loot!
£3 opens a piggy bank savings account. £1 covers membership. For that, your child gets Woody. Then, every 6 months, if they've saved enough, they get the next piggy bank free.
Piggle!
Piggle!
The piggies
are waiting.
Piggle!
Piggle!
Waiting
for you. Piggle!
Piggle!
Down at the
Nat's
Rescue.
Piggle!
How do you do? We say, how do you do?
If you want a filling cereal, the answer's written clear. It says Weetabix.
Yeah!
This is a filling station.
It'll
We're the Weetabix.
A titchy tiny breakfast won't help you start the day.
You make it neat, sweet, mate. If you know what's good for you, you do.
Okay.
The Weetabix. If you know what's good for you.
Okay.
Look what you get when you buy a new wimpy home. This dream kitchen, fully fitted with washing machine, fridge, oven and hob. All famous names like Zanussi, Tricity and Bendix, so you won't need any of those. Carpets in velvet or Berber finishes and curtains are already fitted all over the house with a choice of 18 colour schemes, so... And Wimpy's warm welcome plan now includes a fantastic bonus. Throughout 1984, Wimpy will cut your mortgage rate in half, but the real magic is that it's all included in the price. How's that for a welcome home?
Juice man from Del Monte, he say yes!
Del Monte, what we know about fruit you can taste in our juice. The age of chivalry, pageantry and colour, armour and arms. Now four evocative stamps celebrate the 500th anniversary of the College of Arms, including the arms of the college itself and those of its founder, Richard III, so soon to fall on Bosworth Field. British heraldry, the very stuff of history, at your post office from January the 17th, while stocks last.
I'm just starting out in life, but my standards are already pretty high. That's why I'm so excited about Standard Life. But one day I'll need an endowment mortgage for a home of my own, and savings too. How else could I afford my own transport? I might even want to retire to the seaside on a good pension. And it would be nice to know me and my loved ones are covered by Standard Life Assurance. Standard Life, for all of your life.
What are Mrs. Thatcher's plans for her second term in Downing Street? The Prime Minister will be interviewed live on Weekend World tomorrow at noon on ITV. Well, there's comedy on Channel 4 in a moment in a brand new series of No Problem. Tonight, Beast makes Angel an offer she can't refuse. That's on 4.
once again, big welcome from your Saturday show 321. And this week we've got a great theme for you because it's magic is the theme of our show. We've got some wonderful acts you'll be astounded at a bit later on in our show, you know. And I mean, one theatre critic thinks I'm a magician. He says every time I play his theatre, the audience disappears. I don't know what that means. But it's a great life, and when you think about the great magicians we have, we've got a wonderful one right now in this country, Paul Daniels. I think you'll agree. He's wonderful, isn't he? I mean, Paul really, he's only ever done one thing wrong. That's what...
Mink coat, paper and cash. Well, the money could have come from the missing bag.
Okay, they've started.
Listen, I want you all to treat this like a win on the football pools. Matt, trace all relatives and friends of the Quigley family. Jimmy, I want a register of everything that's bought. I shall want it recovered. George, you stay here with Biggleswade. When he gets over the shock, he should give us a very full statement. I particularly want to know where he got his information on the security van from, who drew up the plans, and where he got his front money from. That leaves one thing outstanding, the press. And I'll handle that one.
I'll have to do some more overtime.
Have you found the money yet, Jack?
I shall be making a statement in...